Attending to the requirements of our customers, we have incorporated into the new version of PLUMBER, on the one hand, the possibility of viewing a whole system's isometry when there are interconnected water networks. And, on the other hand, we've included the capacity to perform the calculation and design of networks in which the supply is done in a descending manner, that is, the distribution is located on the roof of the building level where the sanitary fixtures are located. Reviewing this test project, which you know from previous videos, we see that we have 5 water networks, each one serving the sanitary fixtures at the different levels of the building. In this case, we have combined the ascending distribution, that is, from the floor to the sanitary fixtures, with the new descending one. For example, the level 3 water network, as we see in its general properties, has the descending option up here disabled. Therefore, the distribution is done ascending. Let's see its isometric view from the results tab. This is the configuration that the networks have always had in the program's previous versions, except that now, as you already know, the symbols of fittings such as valves and sanitary fixtures supply are included. Let's close here to return to the project tab. The level 7 water network, however, it is designed to be descending. Let's see its general properties. The descending option is activated. And you will see that, now, floor and network elevations are not similar. Let's close here and go to isometric view. As you see, now the drawing of the supply pipes has the descending configuration from the distribution network located in the roof. The desire of many users finally fulfilled. Certainly, this is not just a graphical addition because, when you perform the calculation and design, pressures will be obtained, taking into account the descending condition as you will see in the project's tables. For example, look at the node, at the network level, that supplies the washing machine here in the pipes table. And, at the same time, also observe the output pressure of the sanitary fixture here in the table of nodes, in the hot water system. Here, since the fixture's supply point is at a lower level than the distribution node, which, remember, is at the roof level, there is a higher pressure. This is one of the peculiarities of this type of network, as you know. Finally, the other new feature is that of being able to present the general isometric view of the system when there are, of course, interconnected networks. This would be the case of the system modeled in this project. From the level 0 water network, the remaining networks are supplied in an ascending manner using interior risers, located in different locations of the plan. Let's go to the isometric view again. In this version, you can now modify the active water network from this same dialog, thus avoiding having to leave it to see other isometries. Then, with the level 0 water network selected, by checking this box, I will be able to have the isometric view of all the water networks dependent on it vertically. Certainly, these types of views are not quite useful at the level of plans but at the level of allowing you to visualize the general distribution scheme. You will see that, based on the coordinates and elevations of each water network, the view is presented from the base level. Also, if I change to level 3 here, checking the view as a whole, We will have the isometric view of the water networks that depend on it. Of course, any view that you generate from this dialog can be exported to an AutoCAD drawing file, as always. What do you think of these new features? Surely will be useful in your next designs with Plumber.